Hello students, welcome back to physics class. Now I would like to discuss with you magnetic effect by due to current carrying conductor. Okay, in this we have three types. Okay, first one we have straight conductor. We have here straight conductor. So now second one we have circular tube. Now third one we have your solenoid. Just you can see here straight conductor. This straight conductor you have seen, okay, wires. So in your home there is a wires are there. That wires are nothing but, or you can say copper wire are nothing but what? Straight conductors. Now circular loops, which is look like what? Circles. Okay, these kinds of what? Circular loops, we can say that what? This circular wires. Okay, these are nothing but what? We can say circular loops. These are look like what? Circles. Now we have here solenoid. Last one is solenoid. So you have seen this kind of, okay, wounds by the what? Copper wire. Okay, this is what? A solenoid. So now we need to discuss more about the what here? Straight conductor. More about the straight conductor. Okay, so to discuss this straight conductor, so let me draw one circuit here. Okay, so let me draw one circuit here. This is one circuit. Now I'll take here one cardboard. So if I, okay, I'll draw here. This is a what? One cardboard. Through this I'll pass. This is one conductor. Just imagine this is what? One conductor. Now this is a conductor. Now here I'll place here one variable resistance. I'll place here one ammeter. Now I'll join this two here. Okay, so this is a negative. Now this is a what here? Positive we have. So just you can see now this is the south end, north end. Okay, so this is my conductor. Now current is flowing from this direction, south to the what? North. And this is what? One here cardboard. To understand the what is the straight conductor, how this will carry the what? Conduct current. Okay, now I'll take the iron fillings. Just I'll spread throughout this cardboard. Okay, throughout this cardboard. Now I'll keep here one key. Okay, this is a key. I'll start this key. Once I started this key, what will be happens here? Just you can think it. So you know it very well. This will be what? Whatever the iron fillings are there, what? These will get arranged themselves in the what? Concentric circles. Why it is happened? You know it very well. Okay, the first point, what we have? When current flows in the circuit. Okay, when the current flows in the circuit, so the whatever magnetic field is generated. Magnetic field is what? Generated. So once the magnetic field is what? Generated means iron. Okay, iron magnetic field is generated, and iron fillings were arranged in concentric circles. What do you mean by this concentric circles? You know it very well. What are the concentric circles? See, concentric circles here. Okay, so look like this, only one center and many of the what? Circles. That is what we can say concentric circles. When the what? Current is flow through this circuit. Okay, and this arrange fillings whatever here are there, these will what arranged themselves in the what concentric circles. Okay, why these are what arranged themselves, you know it very well. When the current is flowing through the conductor, it will gets what magnetized. Due to the magnetized what it will, it has a what magnetic field, and the magnetic field has a what magnetic field lines. Okay, so in this magnetic field lines, in these magnetic field lines will arrange these iron fillings in the what concentric circles. This is what first point here. Okay, well students, now next thing, okay, see here, the strength of this magnetic field, whatever the magnetic field generating here, this the strength of the what magnetic field depends upon the what strength of current. Okay, second point we have strength of magnetic field. Strength of the what we can say magnetic field depends on strength of current passing through it, isn't it? The strength of the magnetic field, okay, the more current means more magnetic field, less current means less magnetic field. Okay, so by that we can say the strength of magnetic field, okay, how much the magnetic field generating here, this is depends on the what strength of the what current passing through the circuit. Okay, so we can say more current, I'll rub this first point. Okay, so if we have the what here, more current, if we have the what more current, more magnetic field. Okay, so magnetic field leads to what represent what magnetic field lines. Okay, if you have more current means more magnetic field, and more circular these rings, okay, or you can say concentric circles, more concentric circles. Okay, more we are passing the what current through this conductor, more means the more magnetic field will be generated. If the more magnetic field generate means more concentric circles will be what generated. Okay, so this is the what we can say here, second point. Now third one, okay, the direction of magnetic field. Okay, the direction of, we can say the magnetic field, okay, the direction of magnetic field depends upon the what direction of current. Okay, so third point we have, I'll rub this one. So third point we have direction of magnetic field depends on direction of current. Okay, direction of magnetic field depends on direction of current. Okay, this is very important point here. Okay, the direction of magnetic field. Now this time the current is flowing from south to north. Okay, if the current is flowing from, this is a what bottom, we can say bottom, this is what top. So if the current is flowing from bottom to top, at that time the circular links will be formed here anti-clockwise. Okay, we can say these will be formed anti-clockwise. The direction of magnetic field has what magnetic field lines. The magnetic field lines are what emerging from the what here and merging at here. That means these are the what anti-clockwise. Okay, these are what here anti-clockwise. We can say by this point is very important, direction of the magnetic field, whatever the what direction of the, if suppose, okay, the current is flowing from top to bottom, what will be happens, can you tell me now? Okay, just you know it variable. If the current is flowing from top to bottom, now direction of this magnetic field is what? Clockwise direction. The direction of the what? Magnetic field is what here? Clockwise. When it is flowing from top to bottom. Okay, but when it is flowing from bottom to top, it is a anti-clockwise. Now fourth point. Okay, so we can say here fourth point, the direction of magnetic field, or you can say if the direction of the current changes, if the direction of the current changes means the direction of the what? Magnetic field lines changes. Okay, okay. So this point, in this only it is direction. Okay, direction of current. Okay, current changes, in this only it is changes. Changes means the direction of magnetic field lines changes. Okay, the direction of magnetic field lines changes. Okay, so this and this point are what? Interrelated. The direction of magnetic field depends upon the what? Direction of current. Okay, magnetic field, it is what? Depends upon the current. The direction of current changes means the direction of magnetic field lines or what here? Changes. Okay, so if the current is flowing south to north means the magnetic field lines are what? From here to here. Okay, if the current is flowing from north to south means the direction of magnetic field and emerging from north and ending from what here? South. Like this it is. Okay, so it is, the points are very important. Now see here, so how the direction of the what? Magnetic field we can find here, the direction of the what? Magnetic field we can find. Okay, there is one rule, and that rule is nothing but what? Maxwell's right hand thumb rule. Okay, we have here Maxwell's right hand thumb rule. Okay, so next, see, I'll rub this one. Now we have next one is Maxwell's right hand thumb rule. Right hand thumb rule. Okay, so what it will tells, how we can find the direction of magnetic field. So imagine that, just you can imagine that. Okay, so right hand thumb. Okay, this is my right hand thumb. Okay, indicating the direction of current, direction of current, and wrapped fingers indicating wrapped fingers are indicating direction of magnetic field. Okay, imagine that right hand thumb. Okay, this is my right hand thumb here. Okay, so if suppose I have what, this is my right hand thumb, this thumb is indicating the what? Direction of current, and this whatever the fingers are, the wrapped fingers, these are indicating the direction of magnetic field, in which what magnetic field lines are what? Generating. This is what the Maxwell's right hand thumb rule. Okay, so I hope this concept you understood very well here. Okay, Well, students, now I'll explain the Maxwell's rule here by taking some examples. Okay, so let me take the similar here one circuit again. So through this you are passed one, and here what we have many circular concentric circles. Now this is what current is flowing. So if you have, this is one battery. Okay, now here we have the what variable resistance. That means it is a rheostat. I'll have the what here, one ammeter. Okay, now current is flowing like this. Now this is a north, this is a what, south. Okay, we can take this is a west, this is what we can have here, east. Okay, now if suppose the current is flowing, if suppose the current is flowing in this direction from south to north, from south to north the current is flowing. Okay, current flow. Okay, so from south to north the current flow means the direction of our magnetic field. Okay, the direction of field we have, it is anti clockwise. Well, students, now here the direction of field is what? Anti-clockwise. Okay, now if suppose the current is flowing, okay, north to south, if the current is flowing north to south, okay, the current flow, okay, it is from north to south, then direction of field, magnetic field, okay, it is what? Clockwise, isn't it? It is about clockwise. If the current is flowing from the what, bottom to top, means it, we can say anti-clockwise, that is south to north. The current is flowing from north to south means it is what? Clockwise direction. This is regarding the what we can say the Maxwell's right hand thumb rule, how we can find the direction of magnetic field. Okay, if the current is, so one more point I'll explain, if the current is flowing from the what, east to west, if it is flowing from east to west, so if the current is flow from east to west, we can say the direction here, okay, the direction of field is what again? Anti-clockwise, isn't it? If the direction of current is what again? West to east, it is west to east, this is the direction of field is, we can say it is again clockwise. Okay, they might be asked this question for 1 marks or 2 marks. Okay, find the direction. So by using the what right hand, Maxwell's right hand thumb rule, we can say that what the direction of the what magnetic field very easily. So what the concept we are studied in this class, we are studied about the what, the current carrying straight conductor. So once the what, you draw the one circuit, take the one cardboard and just fill the what iron fillings, and once you started the what, current flows through the what circuit, there is a what generation of the what magnetic field, and magnetic field leads to generate a what magnetic field lines. So the magnetic field lines will what creates that whatever the what circular concentric circles or circular loops, like what round it will be creates around the what that conductor. Okay, that is the what first point we are studied. And totally the strength of the magnetic field depends upon the what, the strength of the current. If you pass it through the conductor more current, means the whatever the what concentric circles are there, these will be what more. Less current means less concentric circles. That's why we can say that what, that magnetic field which is depends upon the what current, then magnetic field is directly proportional to the what current, we can say here. And change of the what, otherwise the one more thing, okay, the magnetic fields are totally depends upon the what current. Okay, and change of the what magnetic fields also is the change of the what magnetic field lines is also depends upon the what current. Okay, these points we were discussed here. Okay, and also we discussed about the what some these, okay, Maxwell's, by using the what Maxwell's right hand thumb rule, from south to north, then direction of field how it is from north to south, from east to west, then west to east. These concepts we have discussed, and I hope you understood these concepts very clearly.